Addressing journalists today, the fund's deputy managing director, Patrick Kayota, gave the public affirmation on the safety of their money. According to Kayota, as of December 31, 2022, the fund was worth 17.88 trillion shillings, with 78% invested in fixed income, 15% in equities, and 7% in real estate.
Our year starts July 1. In July, collected 107 billion. By the end of December, we had collected 147 billion. Now, there is actually a bit of months, but historically, there are months where you collect more money and there are months that you don't collect as much money. July, normally, people don't send as much money because they send the money in June.
He further revealed NSSF key performance targets for the financial year 2022-2023 after its contributions collections and realized income grew by 22% and 17%, respectively, for half year as at the end of December 2022.
As of the end of day yesterday, just for the month of January, we've collected 121 billion shillings. The month of January, amidst the noise, people actually sending their money, 121 billion shillings. If you compare that to the same time January last year in January, same time, the 24 days between January 1 and January 24th, we collected 97 billion shillings. So we've collected around 24% more this January than we did last January.
On the planned initiatives to recruit savers from small and medium enterprises and formal sectors, Kayota said the fund is ready to fulfill the mandate following the presidential assent to the NSSF Amendment Act of 2022. He said the fund will roll out a recruitment plan after the issuance of regulations by the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development.
The Amendment Act was changed. And the President Gazette, it was gazetted on the 7th of January. It gives us two mandates that are critical: to expand social security coverage, number two, to ensure compliance with the Act. And fulfill this mandate now, we are now developing two strategic pillars. We have to help Ugandans have a willingness to save. Then we have to be able to create the capacity to save with Ugandans.
Kayota further cautioned people against reacting, to assuring that by following the right procedures, savers can easily access their funds. According to NSSF, over 620 billion mid-term access benefits have been issued out to 27,000 beneficiaries since January 2022.
January 2023, the first 24 days, we paid 3,496 members their benefits as far as gross demand. So the point is, when you look at even when the noise was going on, members were still getting their benefits processed and paid. And say it's a responsibility we take, and we're very, very cognizant of that.
The NSSF Amendment Act gave the fund two mandates: to expand social security coverage and ensure compliance. To fulfill this mandate, the fund has developed a plan that revolves around two pillars, which are creating the capacity of Ugandans to save and create willingness by Ugandans to save. Story by Sharon Nabasidye for the news.